In this video, we will discuss how to fabricate a custom orthosis following repair of the extensor pollicis longus tendon, or EPL tendon. Following this video, viewers should be able to describe the therapeutic goals of orthotic intervention following a zone T3 or T4 extensor pollicis longus repair, select appropriate materials required to fabricate a wrist, hand, finger orthosis to restrict wrist and thumb flexion, and develop a step-by-step plan to fabricate a wrist-thumb immobilization orthosis. The EPL muscle originates on the middle region of the ulna and interosseous membrane, then travels distally to insert on the distal phalanx of the thumb. It's responsible for extension and hyperextension of the IP joint of the thumb. It also assists in extension of the MP joint of the thumb and the wrist. Of this muscle can be tested by having the patient place their pronated palm on the table and lift the thumb vertically. Difficulties with lifting the thumb could indicate pathology of this muscle or tendon.
Some important considerations for this orthosis include that the protocol, schedules for immobilization, and progression of rehabilitation depend on the strength of the repair, the stage of wound healing, and are best determined through close collaboration with the physician. The orthosis in this video is simulating a repair in zone T3 or T4. It utilizes a volar design so that the patient can initiate motion gradually and perform scar management and desensitization exercises. Material used for this orthosis should be thick and rigid enough to maintain the joint positioning. A perforated material can help decrease the incidence of skin breakdown due to increased air exchange. However, this also decreases the rigidity of the orthosis, so it's important to consider client factors that may impact how the orthosis is used to make a decision on the appropriate material. Materials that we utilize to fabricate this orthosis includes thermoplastic material, loop and strapping to secure the enclosure, scissors, a heat gun, a wedge for positioning the patient, a towel, splint pan, and pen and pencil. The purpose of this orthosis is to position the patient in an orthotic that minimizes the tension on the repair site, promotes tendon healing, and prevents flexion contractures. This orthosis maintains the MP and IP joints in extension, the wrist is positioned at 20 to 30 degrees of extension, and the CMC joint is positioned midway between palmar and radial abduction. A more conservative approach includes positioning the CMC joint in full radial abduction to prevent extensor lag at the MP and/or the IP joint, which is a common complication following this procedure. The first step is to trace the patient's hands to gain a general pattern. Ensure that you mark the proximal border as 2/3 the length of the forearm. Keep some space between the pencil and the patient's arm to account for coverage that covers halfway on the ulnar and radial sides. Once the material is heated and cut to fit the patient's hand shape, position the patient on a wedge so that the hand and wrist are supported in the desired degree of extension by measuring with a goniometer. Place the material back in the water for the amount of time best suited for the thermoplastic you are working with. Pat to dry and drape in shape to fit the patient by molding to cover the desired areas and attain thumb positioning at 0 degrees. Then use your web space and fingers to smoothly mold the material to contour according to the natural taper of the forearm and the palmar arches. Once the material has the desired shape, critique the orthosis and use the wax pencil to mark areas that need to be trimmed and flared as needed. Ensure the material spans 2/3 the length of the forearm, accounts for the natural taper of the forearm, clears the distal palmar crease to allow for movement of uninvolved fingers, and the pressure is equally distributed for the patient. Or in other words, there's no areas that are causing discomfort or excess pressure on the patient. To make finishing touches to the orthosis, parts of the material can be reheated using a splint pan or heat gun to soften the material for trimming, rounding, rolling and smoothing of the edges, and flaring of the proximal border. A strap was added to secure the thumb in extension. To prevent sliding, two straps were added on the forearm. One of the proximal straps was bifurcated so that one half fits obliquely over the first web space, and the other half can be secured around the forearm. The oblique strap was cut to fit within the first web space without excess pressure. This concludes this instructional video. Some alternative methods for fabricating this orthosis include utilizing a prefabricated orthosis, utilizing a different type of design such as a thumb spica or a dynamic orthosis with a different protocol such as early controlled motion, or utilizing different types of material. Thank you for watching.